Greetings and welcome to an LGR thing, and today is going to be a little bit different because I have some games here that need to be cleaned up and restored a little bit, and I thought I would show you some of my processes for doing that, because after all, every single episode of LGR Thrifts, and even in some of my other videos where I'm showing myself getting game boxes and organizing my collection, someone's always asking, how do you clean these up? Because they have stickers and tape and markers and all sorts of things, or they're smashed up and need to be flattened or put back together. So yeah, I figured I would show some of my ways of doing that. And of course, it is just my way. I'm not necessarily saying this is the only way to clean boxes, but it is what I have found that works for my purposes at least. So I hope that you find something useful here. And that being said, let's get right to it. So the first thing to address are just normal stickers, and yeah, typically with a little bit of care and patience, these can just be peeled right off. Just go slow so as not to damage anything underneath, just in case it ends up being stickier than you anticipate. But then you have some of these price stickers that were put on there by one of the retailers that it was sold at back in the day. Sometimes you try to peel these off and they will either cause damage if you're not careful, or they'll leave a really annoying extra residue underneath, which can just be slowly peeled off, usually with a fingernail. Just again, just gotta be careful and slow so as not to damage anything. And yeah, you're probably gonna be left with even more residue no matter what you do. So at that point is when I just use a tiny bit of goo gone and then just sort of massage it in there with my fingertip, which helps loosen up the gunk. You can do it however though, you don't necessarily need to use your finger. It's just usually I'm using a finger because I'm not doing a whole lot at one time. And then yeah, once that's in there, you just wipe it off with a nice cloth and there you go. The gunk is gone and you're left with a nice clean box. And I do recommend using something like Goo Gone and not anything alcoholic. You do want to use something that is actually not going to lift any of the inks off of the box or ruin the finish or anything like that. All right, moving up on the stubborn scale, and there are these price stickers that are actually security stickers, and these are hugely irksome. So typically what I want to do, since it's more involved, is just break down the box entirely so that I'm not mashing in on the box. We can just keep the whole thing flat, if the box can be broken down at least. And then, yeah, just use a hairdryer and slowly heat this thing up so that we're gonna be able to lift it off here a little more easily, because these stickers are manufactured so that they can't be removed. They actually have a little piece in there that the detectors on the way out of the store detect, so that it's anti-theft kind of a thing. Just use heat and slow peeling and heat and slow peeling and just over and over and over, and eventually you're gonna get somewhere. Hopefully. Some of these I've actually seen where the metal part underneath adheres to the box itself, like it digs into it, and that's just destructive and there's nothing you can do about that. That's thankfully pretty rare though, and usually these come right off after, you know, 5 or 6 minutes of doing the heat and slow peel process. And there you go. Left with some gunk, but that's nothing a little Goo Gone can't fix, and once that's all fingered up and wiped down, it's good. You've got a box that's looking nice and clean. And then just reassemble the box and put it all back together. And yeah, some boxes don't come apart like this. And if that's the case, just do the best you can not to push down on the box too hard when you're removing stickers. Otherwise, you get a box that's sort of smushed in on the front where the sticker was. Okay, next up are some of the absolute worst, and these are price stickers or retailer stickers or even advertisement stickers that got stuck on boxes, and they just have an adhesive and a material that just is, it's awful. EB Games, GameStop, Software, etc., Babbage's, they all used to do this at one point or another. Some of them are actually printed on thermal paper. So when you use the heat method, you're gonna see them turn black. That's normal, that's just going to happen. Just kind of let it happen because you're gonna need heat for this. Sometimes the heat is enough and the adhesive and the sticker itself has held together, but other times like this one, it's just gonna tear up and turn into a mess of paper and goo, and it is awful. So just prepare to spend 10 to 20 minutes. What I do is just try to get as much of everything off of it as I possibly can without damaging the box. Then using some Goo Gone, letting that soak in for maybe a minute, and then using some heat on that to try to get it to just alleviate a little bit more of that goo and that papery texture from the sticker, and then slowly, very carefully peeling that off with a fingernail. or something that is not going to damage it, because these boxes, they can be very easily damaged. And this is also worth noting that pretty much all of this only works on boxes with a very glossy finish. If you're using one with a matte finish that can easily be damaged, you may just want to leave the sticker on there. Sometimes it's worth doing that because you might just ruin the box no matter what you do or how careful you are. But it's especially true, though, if even on a box like this, if you're using one of those sticker removers, it's like a little plastic handheld thing that is used to remove decals from cars. That'll work on things like computer hardware or kind of a metal or plastic surface, but you don't use those on boxes because you'll just ruin it. Anyway, after a long time of just doing the same things over and over, you can eventually wipe down just about every bit of it. You might lose a tiny bit of the glossy finish like I did there, but I still think it looks better than it did with that horrible sticker, that's for sure. Something that you may not run across as much, but I do because I thrift shop a lot at certain Goodwill stores where they do this, and they will take packaging tape and wrap it around the box so that nothing comes out of it. Instead of using like a rubber band or, you know, something else, no, they just put friggin' tape all over it and it sucks. Whatever, it's irksome. So what I do is you want to cut along the edges of the box where the tape is wrapping around the edges. Then you can just start pulling the tape from that edge that you just cut. That way you have a nice clean edge. You're not tearing up the tape on the edges where the tape was originally cut at the store, you know, with the jagged edges, because then you end up with just, you're pulling off strings of tape instead of the tape all at once. And also, you don't want to be pulling the tape over the corner. If the tape is adhered to the corner, sometimes it ends up peeling the side of the box over, and then you just have the front of the box or the side or whatever coming apart. So just cutting along those edges just very, very lightly lets you be able to pull off the tape a little easier. And then at that point, it is just a matter of going very slowly so as not to pull off any of the finish or the ink from the box. Again, this works best on glossy boxes. And sometimes there's areas that it's a little tougher and you might pull and then it pulls too much and then it pulls off some ink. You don't want to do that either. So I, of course, just go back to using just a little bit of heat and going really slowly. You just can't go too slow or too careful with any of these processes. And yeah, eventually the tape should come right off. Another irksome thing is when you find writing on the box. This can be either Sharpie, crayons, or pencils. I've seen all sorts of things. We're going to be dealing with a Sharpie type situation here. Now, sometimes you can just use Goo Gone and it'll come right off. But in this case, it's been on there so long that it's just not going anywhere. It is very handy to use the dry erase marker method. And this really is just using some of the chemicals that are in the dry erase that are going to go in there and mix with the old Sharpie marker and kind of remove all of that stuff that's adhering it to the box, or at least most of it. This has been on there so long that it's not going to turn out absolutely perfectly, but it's still going to remove most of that ink. And then just going on top of that with just the tiniest little bit of Goo Gone, maybe some distilled water, and then just being very careful not to let that seep into anything. In fact, it's good to make sure that there's no open or torn scratch spots on these boxes anyway when you're using Goo Gone or water, because it can actually seep into that and make like a weird stain. It'll soak into the fibers of the paper in the box. But yeah, in this case, it's all right. And you end up with a box that looks a whole lot better than it did, I think, than it did before with the Sharpie. And here's a situation where the permanent marker ink was a little bit more fresh, so that the dry erase method works a whole lot better this way. You pretty much just use the marker, wipe it off with a dry cloth, and there you go. And the final thing that I want to touch on here is getting certain big box games to hold up under their own weight, be a little less flimsy, because there were a lot of these where they actually relied on an inner cardboard box to hold up the shape and to keep the contents from just going stupid inside there. Like right here, this cardboard inner box is what I want to recreate for one of the other flimsier boxes that I have that didn't have that cardboard inner package going on. And for that, you're just gonna need some cardboard that is not too thick and is big enough to cut up. Usually an old shipping box or some kind of cardboard like that will do, that is about an eighth of an inch thick or around 3 millimeters. Just lay your game box down in there somewhere where you're going to have enough space to try and make this thing out of one big piece of cardboard. You could also just cut up individual pieces to each side of the box, but this is going to be a lot sturdier. So yeah, you want to kind of work with the existing folds in the box and also work with the grooves that are in the cardboard going vertically. So just kind of mark that and this really does just take practice. But the idea is that you want to mark all the spots of the box where you know that the cardboard is going to go. And then before cutting, you want to eliminate about a quarter inch or around 6 and something millimeters because when this inner box folds up inside of the other box, it's going to be doubling up in thickness in certain spots. So you don't want it to be too big when it's folded up. And that just takes measuring and patience and remeasuring and then careful cutting. Once that's all sliced up, you should have a rough box idea here with open ends and just see if it fits inside of the game box. And if it does, awesome. Then you can trim off the edges. And for this one, I'm just going to go with a thing that folds in on the top and bottom. And that's it. I'm not going to mess with any other kind of flaps or anything like that. And in order to get those top and bottom folds, what we want to do is flip this over and then very lightly score the box so that it folds perpendicular to those grooves. So don't cut all the way through, don't even cut halfway through, just a little bit so that you can fold it nicely and it'll stay folded. And then yeah, you put it inside the box and there you go. It's not making it perfectly flat. You'd have to do some other things involving maybe a heat press in order to really flatten out this box. Or even what I've done sometimes, if it's a box that it's not super collectible, I will take a piece of cardboard that's really sturdy or even foam core and then just literally adhere it to the front or the back of the box to make it really flat. But in this case, it's fine. I'm just going to put it in there and I'm just happy that the box stands up on its own now and looks half decent. And that's it for this video of tips on how to clean and restore and rebuild some PC game big boxes from the 90s. And you can really use this for all sorts of things, I suppose, for packaging and whatnot. So I hope that you found this useful. And if you did, then awesome. Perhaps you'd like to check out some of my other videos. There are new ones every Monday and Friday here on LGR. And as always, thank you very much for watching.